Good morning, children. Lesson 22, sentences, simple, compound, and complex. Structure of the sentences. According to the structure of the sentence, it is divided into three: simple, compound, and complex. We can see what a simple sentence is. So in a simple sentence, it will have only one finite verb. Children, when I say finite verb, it is a verb that can change its tense according to the subject. The verb which can change its tense or verb can change its form according to the subject is called finite verb. So in simple sentence, you will be able to find only one finite verb. For example, I like chocolate. Here I have only like is the finite verb here. Sheena sat in the park. So the verb sat can be changed according to the subject. When the number of people in the subject changes, the verb also changes accordingly. Like he sits in the park, she sat in the park, anything like that. I sit in the park, like that. Now it is verb will be only one, but the subjects and the objects can exceed one. Okay, a simple sentence may have two subjects, like Sheena and Neha sat in the park. Here the subjects, there are two subjects, Sheena and Neha. But how many finite verbs here? Only one finite verb. A simple sentence may have two objects also, like Sheena saw a squirrel and a sparrow. So here you can see like the, there are two objects also, like a squirrel and a sparrow, two objects also here. Now, it is wrong to assume that a simple sentence is always small. It will be very lengthy also, but we need to see whether there is only one finite verb. If there is only one finite verb without any conjunction, it will be a simple sentence. Okay, so Sheena sat in the park on the wooden bench near the pond, not noticing the squirrel near her feet. So here you can see that there is only one finite verb, sat only. Noticing is not a finite verb here. It is a non-finite verb, which will not change its form. So Sheena sat in the park on the wooden bench near the pond, not noticing the squirrel near her feet. So the simple technique to identify a simple sentence is just check whether there is a finite verb. If there is only one finite verb, it will be a simple sentence. And there should not be any conjunction to connect two clauses. Okay, there should not be any conjunction to give two ideas. It can connect two words, but it should not be like, you know, two sense to connect the two thoughts. Now, a compound sentence, it is made up of two or main independent clauses. Okay, there will be more than two main clause or principal clause or independent. That means the two clauses will not be depending on each other. For example, Neeta sat in the park and the children played on the swings. Here you can see like, you know, there are two clauses and both are main clauses. Why these are main clauses? Because any of these clauses are not depending on the other clause. Like Neeta sat in the park. It is a main clause. One finite verb here and the children played on the swings. That is, played is another finite verb. Even if you remove the conjunction, you can see the existence of two main clauses. It will not lose its meaning. So each clause is of equal importance and does not depend on the other clause. It has a finite verb and the two clauses are joined by coordinating conjunction. That is more important. So in simple sentences, we could never see any conjunction. Whereas in compound sentence, there will be one conjunction, that is coordinating conjunction. But if the compound sentence consists of two clauses, and the subject of both the clauses are same, it is not necessary that the second subject should be mentioned. For example, Neeta sat in the park and read a book. So here it is like, you know, it is Neeta sat in the park, full stop, Neeta read a book. So I can connect it. How can I make it into a compound sentence using and? Neeta sat in the park and read a book. I have not mentioned she again because both she and Neeta refers to the same person. The clause of this sentence is called coordinate clauses as it is joined by the coordinating conjunction. So coordinating conjunctions, when I say, you should remember fanboys. These are the coordinating conjunctions. Now, how can I make a complex sentence? Like, you know, if two sentences are given, if I want to make it into a complex sentence, if from two simple sentences, how if I want to make a complex sentence, I just need to put a subordinating conjunction. Okay, then it will become a complex sentence. So the clause of this subordinating conjunction, we have learned many subordinative conjunctions. So here you can see like one will be the main clause and the other will be the dependent clause. That means a subordinative clause. One is independent, that the other will be dependent. So here see, Sheena sat in the park because it was pleasant. Sheena sat in the park is the main clause. Okay, it can exist itself. It is not depending on the other part of the sentence. Because it was pleasant, it is a subordinate clause because it is starting with a subordinating conjunction because, and it is depending on the main clause for its existence. The clause of this sentence is called subordinate clause as it is joined by the subordinating conjunction. So children, here are some questions for you where you need to identify whether these sentences are simple, compound and complex or complex. Okay, so in simple sentences, there will be only one finite verb and there will not be any conjunction to give the to connect the ideas. Okay, but whereas in the compound sentence, you will be using some coordinating conjunction to connect two simple sentences, and there will be two finite verbs then. And in complex sentences, you will be using one will be the main clause and other will be the dependent clause. Now we can see this exercise. I saw the children participating in the quiz. It is a simple sentence because there is only one finite verb so here and there is no conjunction. Second one, Reena did not like the pudding but she ate the preparation. You can see like two thoughts are conveyed here. Both of them are connected using the coordinating conjunction. So it is a compound sentence. Third one, the dog was hungry. It is a simple sentence because only one finite verb. The dog was in a tight spot as there was food shortage in the country. Here you can see like again there are one is a main clause. The government was in a tight spot. It is a main clause. As there was food shortage in the country, it is a subordinative clause because it is starting with a subordinating conjunction. So this is a complex sentence. She was uncomfortable because of dust allergy. Again, this is a complex sentence because there is because of dust allergy. That is a subordinative clause connected with the main clause. They rode the boat fast and reached the shore safely. This is a compound sentence because here the two clauses are connected using coordinative conjunction. So both are main clauses. Like they rode the boat fast, they reached the shore safely. Next one, Rohit is an intelligent boy with a good grasping power. So this is again a simple sentence because there is only one finite verb here and there is no use of any conjunctions. I hope this is clear to you, simple, compound and complex sentences. And we have done many exercises in the textbook also. Please refer that.